Guess what day it is?
Bloods.
Hey, hey, welcome back to my vlog. If you're new here, my name is Lindy. I am a 46-year-old mother of four fighting breast cancer since January this year. This week, starting tomorrow, is round nine, I believe. I accidentally said round seven last week, but I'm sure we're at round nine, with this being my fourth last Taxol. Has been a good week. I had my bloods this morning. We got them out of my wrist. Only got pediatric tubes again, but she did get it and she got it first time, if not slowly. So yep, starting the week, well, the vlog, with a walk, so we can see that I'm continuing this on. So I don't have Tom today, he's at his dad's, so it's just me on my own. So I'll see if I can pick up the pace a bit. All right, welcome to another week. Ooh. We're nearly halfway. I see that person all the way back there? I overtook him. I feel like I've picked up pace today. I don't know if I have yet though. And as you can see, I'm walking it bald because my head is sweaty and I don't care what people think. I just passed a lady who I'd passed previously and she went past and she said, "You're walking fast." I'm like, "Yes, I am." I actually did try to jog because this is the easiest part to jog. But I can't because I've got my sand shoes on and my feet hurt too much to do that. So no jogging, but it was good that I felt like doing it. Yes, yes. And home 2 minutes faster. I'm feeling it, but I thought while I've got my camera, I'll show you what's going on with these fish. So it looks like Betty is a little tart and has now hooked up with Jack in that corner. So it's changed all my plans. I was ready to start moving fish and now I don't know. But look at all the babies in here. Well, I've put too many in here. But look at them all. They're all happy. And these, sorry, this tank's dirty on the outside, but they're all happy. Everyone's happy. I'm happy. Sweaty and hot, but happy. Oh yeah. All right, let's get this week started. You wanna have a giggle? Look, I got a sweat patch on my mono boob. So I'm completely flat. I know I've never showed my chest, but I'm completely flat and then I've got like a bump. You can't really see it, but it is there. And it's got a sweat patch. It's so fun.
Dance.
Come on, don't stop and keep me going. Do it, let's get it on, move it.
Come on, baby, we do it.
It's Friday. I'm pretty much ready to go to chemo, but look what I'm wearing today. Hang on. Whoops, sorry. Sorry, hang on. Are you going to be able to get me in? Sorry, it's the wrong angle. Hey, here we are. Picked up Jeannie and we are walking the walk. She's just being inconspicuous back there. All right, we're going to actually try the bottom way this week because we're all open. So technically, the easy walk should be open. All right, see you soon. Okay, so it was closed down here, so we have to cut down through emergency and up the hill. That's right, it was a risk worth taking. I do hate these hills though. That's definitely much crueler that way. Oh, that hurt. It really did. Yeah. I've weighed myself and I've put on 2 kilos this week. Told you I was eating a lot. But oh, I didn't even check if we're on time. Are we on time? Oh, right on time pretty much, eh?
Awesome.
Yep. So we'll see how long we wait from 9 o'clock. And Chantelle's not in here. Her appointment was 8:45. There's no way she's already gone in on time.
Hopefully.
I'll have to message her. Look at that. We still have the same background. It's because we've been waiting an hour. It's now 10 o'clock. It's a long wait, hey? And Chantel's already like through and hooked up. And I'm still sitting in the waiting room. And I got a feedback form this time, so I'm going to complain. Because this is every week and it's ridiculous. Ridiculous.
Quickly show the doctor's office because we never get to see it. That's the views out there.
We finally threw after asking. It took another 15 minutes after asking, so an hour and 15 today.
Oh, that's all right. Just got a new hat.
Yeah.
Are my ears always playing up? Yeah, I feel like I've got to pull it down something. That's all right, right?
So we're still waiting. It's been 45 minutes on this side so far. Waiting, waiting. I'm putting in a form today. Oh, actually, I've got to get my... 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2
We will squeeze your butt.
Yeah, you were only just hooked up last week when I was leaving.
If I stop now?
Oh, I'm 8:15, so you should be through before me. Alrighty, with my new hat. Look at it, looks weird.
Looking healthy again this week. Even my skin's holding up really well.
I'll give you an update from what I asked the doctor once I'm all hooked up. Alright, we are up and running with the saline. May the day begin, 11:50. 3 hours after my appointment. I missed out on my salad today, so I got, looks like chicken meat, maybe cranberry. Do you reckon cranberry? We'll try it. But I did get my breaker.
Got the count going on.
You know what that means? Yep. No itchy bum for me today.
Oh, well, I'm a bit tired.
This is Jenny practicing my dance for me. Doing the slow dance, slow walk. We're supposed to do it on the spot too.
It's just so bad. Oh, my blood. Oh, look, it's gone through fast now. Look at it. Go through. There it is. Look, it's all clear.
It had air in the line. Not anymore.
Jenny tells me I've got hair coming back. Where am I looking?
Needed more in the line. Can you feel it?
No.
Oh, I love your head, Linda.
I think she's just trying to make me feel better.
Lovely head, you give such good head.
Oh, no. Look how flat the back is.
Yeah, your mum didn't turn you enough as a baby.
Poppy's head. We're just about done here.
I saw something red on you. I love that.
Yeah, that's weird. I forget that's there. That's saying we're done. I think we've got one more flush.
I have many hairs.
And Jeannie's like, look, here's one. Hang on.
There's your hand.
Where is it? There it is. I can see it. She pulled it out.
Sorry.
I've got minimal, if any, hair, and she pulled out the one long one I have. It didn't hurt. It must have been ready.
It's at the side.
Yeah, see, I never shaved it properly there. And we're done for another week. Three to go. It is 10 to 1, so what's that? 9 to 12 is 3-4 hours. Is that right? I don't know. Something like that.
Thanks,
Two. Cheers.
No, it's 10 to 2, I lied. Did I just say 10 to 1?
We're getting recorded.
I'm always recording as I'm walking out of here.
Check out TikTok.
All right, so that's it. We're done. Three to go. Nothing exciting, honey. Nothing exciting. It's just a long day because a lot of long waiting. This is Jeannie. He said she didn't want to be on camera. Where's our button? So I thought I'd just update you on the two things I did ask the doctor. One thing was asking about when I start my hormone blockers, and I don't start them until the end of radiation, so that's good. Because I know some people start it as soon as chemo's finished, as they're going through radiation, so I'm not complaining that waits a bit longer for me. And as for getting scanned and that afterwards, I don't get any more scans. Basically, that's it. I see the oncologist every 3 to 6 months, but I don't get scans, I don't get any checks unless I get bone pain or I find a lump on my chest wall that I'm concerned about. But so I don't like that. I would at least like a scan yearly. Do you know what I mean? Like, I've had cancer. It's the chance of it coming back is there. Like, why would you not just check? He said, you know, putting us through that much radiation for no reason. I don't know. Mental health seems like a good reason to me. So we'll see how I feel. And as time goes on, if I just get nervous or whatever, I'll just make up bullshit so I can go and get a scan to make me feel better. So yeah, they're the two things I was concerned about today. No issues with the chemo going through. Never is. Knock wood. Got my dance done. Wasn't 100% happy with it, but it'll do. It was a hard one. That's it. I'm back home. I'm just waiting to go pick up the kids from school. So yeah, it was a good day. Number 9 is done. 3 to go. Look, I've got enough fingers. 3 to go. 3 to go. Can you believe we are that close to the end now? And my neuropathy and my fingers are better. It's all good. Oh, I ran into the counsellor. I remember I ditched her. And then she kept trying to ring me and I just avoided her. I just, like, what did I gaslighted? No. Ghosted her. I ghosted my psychologist. And then she was in there today and I'm like, oh, maybe she won't recognise me because I don't have hair. But no, she's like, hey, Lindy. And I'm like, oh, shit. Hi, sorry, I didn't mean to ghost you. Look at me, I'm doing fine. I don't need a psychologist. So we've just come to... Oh, I just got spat on. So we've just come to check the sky to see if we can come walking, and the fact that I just got spat on clearly says no. But look, the clouds aren't moving. Is that abnormal? Don't clouds move all the time? Don't they move all the time, or do they sometimes just sit still?
I've seen them sit still many times.
Impressive looking cloud, though. I feel like a big lightning's going to come out of it and get me. So Joe reckons what it is that the clouds are moving at the same speed as the earth rotating. It's not that the earth has stopped rotating, like I said.
If it had stopped rotating, we'd be pretty much dead by now.
Why? What does the rotating earth do?
The world rotates about 5,000 or something kilometers per hour.
Is that what keeps us down here?
No. I always think it's air that gives us gravity.
I don't know, you're not asking me. Look at my hat, don't you think it looks good? I don't know what to do with it now that I've got it. It feels comfortable though, but it looks... I've got to figure out what to do with it. Yeah, but a walk is off the cards for the Savo. Ooh, I just had my medicinal cannabis consult. And she said, and I didn't know, it can help the neuropathic pain. But I told her my main concern was sleep. And so she said that they use oil to help with sleep. So, yes, so I have an appointment with... That was the appointment with the nurse. So I have an appointment with the doctor next Wednesday and we go from there. So, yes, I might get a good night's sleep soon. Yay! Don't think it'll help the hot flushes, though. I didn't ask. See, we didn't go for a walk. Oh, lucky. This doesn't sound like a fun one to be caught in.
Hello, hello.
Oh my God, look at, oh God, look at me. See what I look like? My face is getting fat. And look, I got no eyeballs left. No eyeballs. No eyebrows or eyelashes left. I'm really looking the whole cancer victim now, aren't I?
Oh,
anyway, we're on our walk. I'm with Joe today because Tom didn't want to come. And Joe needs to swap shoes with his dad. So, we thought we would walk to his dad's house.
Tuesday.
Oh, good point. So yeah, we're going on a completely different walk, and this is a longer walk. Though Joe's going to ditch me up at the 7-Eleven, and he's going to run to Dad's from there because we're going to run out of light. But what day is it, Joe? Sunday arvo.
Sunday.
So yesterday I felt a bit, I don't know, I wouldn't say crappy, but just a bit achy, and my fingers and toes have started hurting again. So I ended up taking a sleeper last night because for the two nights before that I've slept maybe 3 hours. And so last night I slept from about 8 o'clock till about 5 o'clock this morning. And then I slept another 4 hours today.
Okay.
Oh, thanks. Look, Joe got me flowers.
Dandelions.
So yeah, so I had a good week last week, and it's not a bad week this week, just I'm a bit more icky. Sort of, I don't know how to explain. I look like shit though. Anyway, off we go.
See that house with the white back there? This one?
The lady just came out and is like, I don't know, she was calling me. And then she's like, Lindy, she knows me off TikTok. Hey! That's really weird that people know me off TikTok. I'm up to 12,000 followers on TikTok though. And I'm actually up to nearly... nearly up to 500 followers on YouTube, so I'm slowly reaching people. But yeah, that's a bit weird when
people live in Toronto too.
Come running out to go, I know you!
A lot of people live around us.
Yeah. Anyway,
I caught that little path.
So we've come from up there.
We could have just walked down there.
I couldn't. Look, we're going down here. Make sure there's no
druggies
or. Oh, fucking hell! Let's get the shit. That was just a bird. Oh, what's down there? That scared the shit out of me. Oh, I didn't even know there was actually water here. There you go. Ooh, this is like slimy. Okay. What's over this side? Oh, look, it's like a pond. There'd be turtles and stuff in there. Wouldn't there? It's a bit dirty.
Probably needles.
Really, do druggies hang around down here?
Yeah.
Do they? Really?
A lot.
Oh, it's nice to know, hey? All right, we're on the other side of the road.
Too fast for you. I'm gonna overtake you.
Yeah, the trees are nice. There goes Joe. Hello, it is Monday afternoon and it's Tom and I this afternoon. Just doing the usual block because yesterday's ended up being 3.6 kilometers and my feet are still sore. This one's only 2.6, 2.7, pending. But I've got new shoes, look.
Oh, can't see them, hang on. Where are we? There they are.
They're just cheap Nikes, but they are better than what I needed, but I still need to get inner soles for them. But I've got new shoes. Going a different route this day. Today. Going through the park. Oh, it stinks though.
Yeah,
but just taking a different route. All the Australian gum trees. My kids played on these playgrounds when they were little. And then there's bike jumps over there.
Saying how many people are out, and they are. Ah, look how many people are active.
Got people on this oval. You can't see, but down there is exercise equipment, which was people were on. Then we got over here. Oh shit, sorry. Basketball courts. No one's there. Then we had people on the bike jumps. And there's been so many people out walking today. So it's good to see so many people active, I think. I don't know if we're all just excited to be out of lockdown. That's tall, that's behind me. There's Tom. Tell you what, I'm tired today. It's hard today. My fingers were so sore and toes were so sore last night. Then sore today, but not as bad. Here he comes. Yeah. Hey, oh, I did actually get out of my pajamas, look. Today is the day I am going to be moving fish around in my tanks. I'm nervous. I'm so nervous to be moving because I'm moving big fish. This tank is getting some big fish in it. There's lots of changes happening and I'm really nervous and I've been avoiding it and it's here. Wanna have a look at my tanks before I start though? Hang on, excuse my mess. It's always a mess, hang on. Oh, this one needs its outside of its tank cleaned, but nothing's happened in here. This is she's not looking so good, sorry. I just saw my, I don't know if she's alive. That bristle nose there is not looking good. Anyway, I do think my male, I do think these bristle noses are breeding, but I can't tell. Anyway, we've got them. The babies that I put too many babies in, there's Junior at the top. Some of them may get eaten when I move some big fish in there. And this is the tank, the last time you'll see the tank like with these fish. This tank is changing. Oh, look at Hawk. So we have, who have we got? Bob. That's Bob and Loki and, oh my God, my mind. Bob, Loki and Tank are the big fish. Hulk is the pleco. And up this end, I don't know if I've told you, Betty is a whore. Sorry for the language. But Betty has moved up. Oh, there's Jack. And Betty has moved up here with Jack. Oh, there's Betty. And Betty has had babies. Well, we've got, sorry, the tanks. I can't clean it because it's, you know. But we have all little eggs all over here. I don't think any have hatched yet. I haven't looked. But yeah, so that changed everything now that Betty has two baby daddies. So Jack is going to be a dad. So that's those tanks. So yep, today it's happening. I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous.
Here is Bob and Loki. They're just acclimating to the water.
So they've come out of here and are going into here. It's finally happened. And I'm getting Bruce and Maggie out, like I said. And I'm going to try. It's been so hard getting those babies out. There are a few particular ones I want to get out, but I want to put one or two into the 6-foot tank and watch them as Red Texas grow out. That's it. That's where we're at. all right. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm so excited.
Bob, and he's pretty stressed.
Like he's pretty stressed too. Mm-hmm.
Sorry, mate.
So that is their home. That is their home.
Yeah, but they're in there, and they look okay. They look okay. They've just got to find their new space and figure out what's going on.
Got him. Oh, I'm sorry, Bruce.
Hang on, darling. It's okay.
There you go.
Hang on.
Sorry, darling. There you go. Good boy. Okay, now for Maggie. Hello. Was that first day too?
girl, Maggie. I'm sorry, Bruce. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right. It's all right.
There you go.
Oh, hold the cup. All right. Who's coming first? Who's coming first? They've literally both gone in, so that works well for me. Okay, you ready, babies? This is it. We'll get out of the way, Linda.
Looks like Maggie and Bruce did well. Look at Maggie's colours under this light. Looks like they did well last night. I did see Bob attacking Loki, though, chasing him around this morning, and he's now terribly hiding down in there. So I will keep a very close eye on them. You can turn around. So you can see he's been a bit banged up on that side, but that happened like when he first hopped in, I think. So I'll just keep an eye on that. There's Loki. So you can see how bad he was attacked. I'm just glad I found him in time. So he's in the medicated tank. Thankfully, I had this one up and ready. That's all the babies on their own now.
So, hi. So it is Thursday afternoon. So I thought I'd better end this video to get ready for tomorrow's chemo. So how are we going to end this out? Let me see. How's my week been? I've had a good week. I have been more tired than normal. So I had a sleeper earlier in the week because I'm not sleeping. I have insomnia. But then when I had that sleeper, I've been sleeping a lot since then. Waking up a lot, but still sleeping a lot. So yeah, I'm just a little bit more tired this week. My neuropathy has actually been pretty good, to be honest. I can't complain, honestly. It's not got worse in my finger, and I haven't had much in my feet. I honestly can't complain about neuropathy. My fingernails were sore earlier in the week, but have gotten better. You can definitely see them getting darker. But they actually feel pretty good at the moment. Oh, there you go. Look yucky, but they feel good. So that's pretty good with that. I've actually been a bit sore under here since I went to the physio. Have I done anything about it? No. Just sort of said to myself a couple of times, gee, I'm sore. let me see. I did a video today. I thought it was funny, actually. A TikTok. And in it, I kind of fall at the camera and I saw hair. Can you see it? I can see it. Can you see it? Look. All that fluffy. Look. I can see it. Can you see it? Today is the day. I don't know what time it is because my phone's flat. My watch is flat. But I have hair. I have hair nowhere else. Actually, I have it all over my arms, but I have literally lost it everywhere else. My eyelashes. Look, I still got one or two hanging on, but I can definitely, they're definitely coming out still. And what are we at? It's been 10-11 weeks since I finished AC. Yeah. Uni. Now, I don't know how I want to word this. I can word it negatively, or I can word it positively. I'm going to word it positively, and I'm going to say I finished my grad cert in professional nursing. Hang on. Let's do that again. I finished my grad cert in professional nursing. So, what really happened is, I just got tea on me, is that I quit out of my master's. So I was doing my master's in acute care and nursing, something like that. I deferred at the end of last year due to I was going through a court case from childhood sexual assault, and my brain just went numb and I couldn't focus, so I did defer then. That was deferred over Christmas. Then I did defer the beginning semester because of my cancer diagnosis, and I didn't know how it was going to be and whether I'd have time and blah, 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 blah. And so I have already completed four subjects. And so then I did enroll to two subjects this semester, wasn't I brave? And then I pulled out of one. And now I've pulled out of the second one. I've spoken to the uni. I can get my grad cert, which can still give me career progression, but it gets me out of the degree that I've been wanting to get out of for a while. So yeah, that was my big news. I'm excited. I have finished uni. No more uni. I've told Shane I'm not allowed to do uni again. Bloods. There you go. We did go in here today because I hadn't drunk enough water. And I had no veins, and I just said, look, just go in there. And it was a nice, quick, easy bleed. It hurt, but we did it. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for following along this week. Thanks for following my journey altogether. Thanks for any comments. I appreciate you all. And have a great week. Look forward to seeing you again.
Get it on, move it. Come on, baby, do it. Huh.